Greetings and welcome to Points of View. In late 2011, Oklahoma Republican Senator Tom Coburn released his 2011 Waste Book. This is a list of government-funded projects that he considers a waste of taxpayer dollars. One of the items concerns a study being done at the University of Kentucky to determine, of all things, how cocaine enhances the sex drive of Japanese quail. You heard me right, Japanese quail. This absolute governmental brain fart involved two grants from the National Institute of Health. First, in 2010, $181,406. Then in 2011, an additional grant of $175,587. This study, and I use the term loosely, is supposedly trying to verify clinical observations that people using cocaine are more likely to engage in high-risk sexual behavior. Maybe it's just me, but I honestly don't think that it's necessary to spend hundreds of thousands of dollars on finding out something that I'm sure tens of thousands of police and social workers could tell you for free. And as amazingly stupid as this so-called study is, that's not the worst part. Even more unbelievable than the story of this example of what I call stupid science is the fact that there is a post on the Scientific American blog by a writer identified only as this iCurious Brain. Sounds like a title of a trauma movie, doesn't it? This gigantic brain, another good trauma movie title idea, goes out of its way to actually defend this example of wasteful spending. Let's slam a bra on this iCurious Brain. Obviously, they need one to hold in their gigantic brains. Frankly, I don't see how there can be any defense of government spending taxpayer dollars on something this ridiculous. In my opinion, that grant money would have been much better spent on locating and destroying cocaine plantations, processing facilities, distribution networks, and putting the people involved in jail for as long as possible. Don't get me wrong, I'm very much in favor of science and the advancement of knowledge, but really, I just can't see how something like this can be justified. When it comes to cocaine and other drugs, I think we need a lot less funding of oddball studies like this and a lot more Chuck Norris-style action. Finally, I've got to say that an internet handle like this iCurious Brain makes me think that perhaps the person behind it should think about the following two quotes. Number one, if I claim to be a wise man, it surely means that I don't know. Kansas, Wayward Son. Number two, professing themselves to be wise, they became fools. The Bible, Romans 1:22. That's my point of view. Thanks for watching.